Hey. It's Denise here with another video, and I want to talk to y'all today about natural hair court order. Because everybody's talking about the natural hair court order, and he said this, and they said hair braiders weren't supposed to be regulated, and all of these. Nobody's really detailedly looked at this court order and explained it to you. But I'm here to do that today. So right now I'm going to share my screen with the court order, and we're going to talk about exactly what was awarded to hair braiders in the court order. A, B, C, and D. Okay? Thank you. Now let's look. All right, while it's loading, here is the award, official award of the agreed court order by Lillian and the Minnesota Board of Cosmetologists, which created the Natural Hair Braiders Registration. Now, in the beginning, it goes and it states the stipulated facts and finding of what hair braiding is and corn rolling and wrapping and all these different things. But the meat of the order is where I want to get to. So it's not fair for me to pass up right here where they was saying these are the amount of hours that a cosmetologist have to do. And as you see, natural hair is not included in any of them, and they all mostly add up to 1500 hours of instruction. Okay, so they found out that, like I said, cosmetology did not include anything for natural hair. So they created the natural hair registration in Minnesota. Now, since the three people that was being suing the cosmetology, they went in and sued the cosmetology board. It's not the board of cosmetology suing these hair braiders. These hair braiders are going in suing the cosmetology board, talking about the Fifth Amendment, as you can see right here. The 14th Amendment in the United States Constitution, citing that they want economic liberty. Now, half of these people that are citing this economic liberty in America, the freedom to do this stuff, came from Africa. Might be Liberian, Nigerian. I believe they may have had one American DOS in Iowa through the Institute of Justice to walk in there and cite and create this form of legislation, which really created a breakup amongst black salons because they're not messing with white salons' economy or black people money. They and these people are actually sending their money out to, of the country to synagogue and all of this to take care of their other families. Now they went in, like I said, and they sued. Now let's get to what I want to get to, the agreed order. Okay, this is the agreed order. The agreed order permanently enjoined and restrained from constructing and the definition of cosmetology to include hair braiding is defined in this order. So they permanently enjoin, mean they cannot restrain from constructing the definition of cosmetology in and including hair braiding in the definition. So how is they wanting to put hair braiders in cosmetology? They can't. Number one, coming out the gate in the order, say no, cosmetology cannot regulate or enjoin these people in their stuff. Okay, right here it say that it would they can't be licensed services. So where all these people states are going and saying they want to make it a license, they right, they can't make it a license, but she did make it a permit. See, it's different. That's why it's called a registration. She permanently enjoined them from restraint from them enforcing this 551A, which is the cosmetology board, and seeking any criminal sanctions, deportation, and all of that, because that's what they were saying they'll do to these hair braiders. Okay, now let's get to the real meat and bones on number eight. Okay, well, start with number seven. Number seven is where she told the Board of Cosmetology and any of their successors, so anybody that comes to the Board of Cosmetology, that they were enjoined from messing with a hair braiding or promulgating any amendments or any laws towards a hair braider. She defined what hair braiding is, what hair braiding is, African style braiding. She defined it as natural hair care. She included that it has sewing, weaving. That's the part that I'm concerned with. Okay. She also included that it has natural hair fibers, synthetic hair fibers, wigs, customized wigs. So at that point in the law, if she was going to call it customized wigs, it's supposed to be called a hair prosthesis, like fake hair, fake leg is a fake prosthesis. It's called hair and scalp prosthesis. Okay. And her extensions. All right. Then she included shampoo. So when they were telling people they couldn't have a shampoo bowl, how? She included shampoos. She included permanent penetrating colors as something you could not use. Okay? She didn't say anything about depositors. Right here is where I take stance with. She included simple braiding devices. All right? In the simple braiding devices, you have clips, combs, curlers, curling irons, hairpins, rollers, scissors, which is a sharp needle, which is another sharp, and thread. She told you what hair braiding services were. Hair braiding services were defined in the top, members of the public for a fee or other consideration. Quote unquote, other consideration, because they're calling hair braiders underground, which means illegal. Okay? Like prostitution and marijuana and cannabis. All right? And included natural hair care in that. So when you're saying you're a natural hairstylist and you're a natural hair care, yes, you are a hair braider. Okay? She defined what a hair braider is, a person that performs these services. Right here. Number 8, she told the Board of Cosmetology again that they were enjoined, but this time when she told them that they were enjoined in good faith and expeditiously as possible to promulgate an amendment to their rule book substantially equivalent in the form of content to include the following exemptions. Okay, take this stuff away from the Minnesota laws and rules consistent with the terms agreed with this order. A, she came out and told them that the cosmetology board 55A and the Board of Barbers 554 are to be construed and not prohibited to regulate. They cannot regulate a hair braider, hair braiding services, or hair braiders. Okay? The barber board or the cosmetology board. She only told them two, they cannot regulate these people, right? Only them. Then she came and said what it is that she's giving them. She giving them hair braiding, simple hair devices, hair braiding services, and hair braiders going to be defined in the Minnesota law book, all right? But she also says, and, which she could have made another sentence, but she didn't. And hair braiding services, and hair braiders are to be construed as exempt from the Minnesota rules, the barber rules, and the cosmetology rules, okay? And the Minnesota rules is the Department of Commerce, which that was the whole thing was dismantled besides enjoined. Now, they're saying that the hair braider services, and hair braiding is not regulated by the cosmetology board. However, she didn't mention simple hair devices, okay? If she had a mention simple hair devices, which is right here, she left that still in their book. So they regulate and have control over simple hair devices. In C, she wrote, hair braiding and hair braiding services shall be construed in as included in the definition of unregulated services. So hair braiding and hair braiding services is unregulated. However, she did not include simple hair devices as an unregulated service. Only hair braiding and hair braiding services. Simple hair devices and hair braiders are still regulated. All right. However, they just regulated by the multi-member agency or somebody else. Because remember, she said that the Board of Cosmetology and the Barber Board couldn't regulate them. Also, she went on with D and said in the ordinance by local units of government that prohibit or regulate any manner regulating to training, testing, or license of her braiders, her braiding, and her braiding services are pre-exempt by this rule, meaning that they are exempt. The local government, the cities of St. Paul, the cities of Minneapolis, cannot regulate a herb braider. It has to be a multi-member agency that's regulating the herb braiders that has went through the necessary chains of action. Then she also went on to, let's look at number 11 is what I like. Number 11 is what she went on and she told the Board of Cosmetology and the herb braiders and the herb braiders as barbers, barbershops, cosmetologies, all this training would go up under her braiding, and the parties within the agree, the party here within agree that defendants' advocacy, and defendants were the Board of Cosmetology, because remember the herb braiders and the Institute of Justice sued the Board of Cosmetology. So the Board of Cosmetology advocate in support of enactment of such health and safety standards by the Minnesota legislature will not constitute a violation of this agreed order, and that the defendants will not be subject to any sanctions in court. Now, what she's talking about is the Board of Cosmetology has a gag order right here that the only thing that they can do is come and advocate in good faith in support of enactment of health and safety standards. So when the Board of Cosmetology comes to legislature and saying that they're neutral, they are lying. They can't be neutral. They have to be in support. Okay? So I just want y'all to see that this is all a facade, and that Brina Moran, I'm not just attacking her and I'm not just attacking legislature. If they all want to follow by Isabella Goldmass's law, and they want to bring up this court order from Isabella Goldmass, follow it by the strict rules. Create the natural herb board like she asked for, and stop this ludicrous craziness. Institute of Justice, you lost. Allow these people to make this a bona fide job. It's not an underground thing that people are doing, which is underground is you don't get no loans for business loans for underground. Underground is you're not even on a federal level. You don't get no income tax. You don't get nothing. So right now, while you getting a permit and you getting registration and licenses in some states, you need to advocate to these senators and state representatives and Congress people that you want to keep your registration. All right. So again, this is the Eco Herb Braiders Association. Oh, I can put it right there. I put it over here, Denise. And this the Board of Cosmetology. You can go over here and you can look at their herb braiders registration. When you first come to the Board of Cosmetology, this is what it looks like. Okay. It looks like this. And then you go on here and you ask, go for herb braiding. Because remember, they can't regulate a herb braider. So herb braiding has its own whole little section over here. And you can look and read it, all the bulletins, and there you can find this court order and go over and read it for yourself. And know that at this time, Isabella Goldmass was being in favor of black women and black people, and she created a board that we should have a board. We should have members. We should have staff. We should have everything that everybody else is getting. All these cosmetology boards in every state is enacting they're enacting esthetician licensing and getting $1 million out the government funds. And Brina Moran ain't turned no bill in to get rid of them. Okay. While they using Anita just like you and I. So I just wanted to bring y'all this video so y'all can see. I got a lot of people coming back like as if wow, or as if I might be a little crazy or whatever. But no, this is really true. And you need to advocate for yourself and on behalf of your kids, because if these people don't pay taxes, in these local areas, they sending them money home, or anybody, they not paying taxes as a local business, the school is suffering. That's where they get their money from, to buy curriculums and things like that in the black neighborhood. These white people, they really not worried about it. They not using no needle in their head. And they kids don't go to these schools really that much. You get what I'm saying? And if they are doing some braids, they only wearing them a day. They not wearing them too long. And they not going wearing braids to a job. Most of them got their own businesses. They not getting fired. Okay? So what she's advocating and talking more and speaking more to braids, she need to speak more into that law and look at the wigs and weaves, and that this could be a bona fide profession, not just a coming up profession. No, this could be a bona fide health profession for black women. Thanks.